Ladies and gentlemen, you know who our guest is today, and I know that he has a few years for you, and I think a great many prayers have been answered in his presence.
I certainly have some words, and I would like to read them. I usually like to speak extemporaneously, but we have our people being held prisoner. I'd like to just preface my remarks by one simple statement. What I say today, what you record, what you speculate upon, is heard throughout the entire world within 24 hours. A simple speculation on your part could cause the death of my dear friend Tom Sutherland or Terry Anderson, Joseph Scipio, or any of the other hostages. And I would ask that you would be responsible and that please do not engage in unreasonable and unrealistic speculation. Be intellectually honest. I ask of you, I plead for you. I am worried about what you might say or someone else might result in a death of somebody that I love. I don't want that on my conscience, and I don't think I want it, you want it on yours. So I have a brief statement that I have written, and I'm happy to read it. It's a thrill to be here. And Mr. President, you can't really imagine, and Mrs. President, can't imagine my joy of being here with you on this very special day. 17 long months, I never lost hope of being a free man again. I prayed long and hard, and my dear family, my six wonderful children are with me here today, and my friends, they kept the faith, and they never lost hope, despite many, many frustrations. And that knowledge kept me going. And freedom is a very precious gift, and I really learned it in a very personal manner. Freedom is a very precious gift, and one that we Americans sometimes take for granted. When freedom is taken away, the loss is immense. But that same hope, and that faith, and that optimism that sustained the founders of our country, of this great land, during the periods of our adversity as a nation, also kept my spirits high during my long captivity. Mr. President, I know that you and many others in and out of the administration of this government have worked long and hard on my behalf and on the behalf of the other captives, and you continue to do so for the others that are still being held hostage. And in particular, there are a number of independent people, religious leaders, and others that deserve special praise for their independent efforts. Terry Waite, who is one of those great humanitarians, who has given so much of himself so that I may be free. Terry Waite did it as a free man, free of all governments and any type of deal. Terry did it as a humanitarian. The families of Terry Anderson, Tom Sutherland, Joseph Scipio, and the other innocent people still being held hostage should not give up hope. Contact by you, Mr. President, and others in the administration, and especially those very special people in the State Department. We have maintained frequent contact with our families to help our dear ones sustain their hope. And I know, Mr. President, that you have sought our freedom from the day that the first American was taken hostage. And I know that you have not rested, nor will you rest until every American is owned free. Mr. President, you really have my eternal gratitude. You're the leader of a truly great country, and I'm proud to be an American, and I really want to thank you very, very much. Quite a man. Thank you, and please, please, in your comments and your evaluation, be responsible.
Mr. President, the Iranians are saying that if you'll release some of those weapons, they'll intercede to free the rest of the hostages, will you?
Bill, I think you do this statement. This is just exactly what I tried to say last night. There's no way that we can answer questions having anything to do with this without endangering the people we're trying to rescue.
So, can you just tell us whether Secretary of State Schultz agrees with your policy or disagrees and has protested as has been reported?
We have all been working together.
And what? Secretary Schultz supports the policy and so does Cap Weinberger?
Why not dispel the speculation by telling us exactly what happened, sir?
Because it has to happen again and again and again until we have them all back. And anything that we tell about all the things that have been going on and trying to affect this rescue endangers the possibility of further rescue.
Your own party's majority leader says
you're
rewarding terrorists.
Please, you didn't hear what I said at the beginning. Unreasonable speculation on your part can endanger their lives. I would like to take some time now and talk, but this is a day of joy for me. I have my children inside. I want to share it with them. And I want Kerry Anderson to share the same joy with his family. And I want Tom Sutherland to share the joy with his family. And in the name of God, would you please just be responsible and back off? Thank
Mr. Jacobson, how are we to know what is responsible and what is not?
How about your TV aircraft?
I think there's a story in there somewhere.
Hey, Pat. Hey, Pat.
We're still live, gang. There you go.
Part of the whole.
If you're responding, I don't know.
Well,
sounds like quite a guy.
That's an echo.
Watch my lip!